Just as all other spiritual instruments have a correct way of helping us, the pendulum also is helpful in its own scientific way. But just as it is the case of any machine discovered by man, the capability of using it properly or not depends upon the person who uses the pendulum. Once again, the deciding factor is man, not the pendulum. Just as even in the case of the most modern electronic equipment, the use or disuse depends upon the person who handles it. Just as the most scientific computer, when properly fed by the information and data, then only it responds to correct results. But when there is something defective in the feeding of the machine, the results may go wrong. If we remember this, and if the radiesthetician has the capacity to keep his mind above any impression, then every result is bound to be correct. That is my opinion about radiesthesia. Medically means, spiritually and medically speaking, the cause of sclerosis, the immediate cause of sclerosis exists in the psychological inequalities of a person continuously entertaining in his mental mechanism. If the person has unavoidable difficulties in his thought pattern, sclerosis is an inevitable result. For example, if a person has bankruptcy terrifying him from the social levels, every thought of him will be influenced by his thought of bankruptcy. If there is a constant thought of hatred towards anyone, all his good thoughts are also tinged with it. It first creates a sclerosis of his thought pattern, and that particular spot of the thought pattern will receive this sclerosis in the stuff of the mind. In course of time, that particular corresponding spot on the physical body will receive the carbon copy of that spot, and that establishes as a spot for the future sclerosis in course of time. Just as repeated anxiety of the same type creates a spot of choking in one part of his throat apparatus, and in course of time, that particular spot on the physical foot pipe, that part of the alimentary canal from mouth to gaster, will continuously receive that particular spot of anxiety and anguish. In course of time, it results in either a spasm or a spot of cancer in that pipe, in the tube. Similarly, the spot of sclerosis will form according to the spot on the mental apparatus. A repeated negative thought like fear or jealousy or anger or hatred or suspicion will create a sclerotic spot on the mental thought pattern, and when it continues for a very long time, it finds its corresponding spot on the physical body. That is the true cause of sclerosis. That is the reason why though that spot is treated with my medicine repeatedly, even though it disappears with the medicine applied by any method, once again it appears on the same spot, and it, the tendency to form sclerosis in the same spot continues until the person dies. But if the thought pattern were to be cured in some way or other, then the physical spot can be forever cured by any simple medicine. Because once cured, it will never recur when it is removed in the thought pattern. So the result, sum total, is that a repeated negative thought works as a spot for sclerosis before it appears on the physical body. From the mental plane, it descends to the nervous system through the cerebrospinal nervous channels, and afterwards it condenses at a spot. The thought energy travels like electric current, and when the flow is in the scientific and proper direction, it completes the circuit and serves the purpose through the nervous. But if there is thought sclerosis, then the nervous system also responds wrongly, and a phenomenon like short circuit in the wires of electric current forms sclerosis in thought current. And the physical tissues that are scorched at that spot form the physical point for sclerosis. Leukemia. It belongs to a category of cancerous constitution, and just as any other cancer formed on any part of the body indicates only that the person is having cancer, when cancer is localized, it is called cancer. When it is not localized, it takes the form of leukemia. But the truth is, long before the body receives leukemia or any localized cancer, the disease exists in man, not in any part of the body. And the formation of that particular disease takes not less than 7 years before it is understood. And generally speaking, lack of affection during infancy, or children adopted and taken away from the original parents, or children totally ill-treated by idiotic parents, those children develop the cancerous constitution in course of time. And when the mental and vital cancer has no opportunity to manifest upon any part of the physical tissues, it takes the form of leukemia. Even in the case of physical cancer, which can be located in any part of the body, it is a pity that the modern medical science does not understand that cancer exists with the person, not with that particular part. That is the reason why, even though it is temporarily suppressed or cured in the place where it appears, the parts roundabout will be affected and the doctor calls it secondaries. This is because cancer exists in the person and treatment is given to the tissue affected.
The patient.
Cancer continues in the person and again manifests in another place. And to call it secondaries is unscientific. Especially leukemia, the main cause of leukemia is located by the ancients as the lack of affection from the elders during childhood. Another cause is gonorrheal poison. When not cured in one generation, it creates a constitution called psychosis in the modern homeo system. And in the third or fourth or fifth generations, there will be a mental condition which we can call mental cancer. The main characteristic is a continuous keynote of jealousy in the psychological mechanism. And it will be always intertwined with suspicion. All the psychological activity will be conditioned by these two motives. And the person generally lives a life of too much caution and too much tension. Many times leukemia is the result. This is the second cause of leukemia according to the ancients. Generally, it allows six generations to multiply, but if we do not care to properly cure it, cure psychosis in the sixth generation, it results in a disease like leukemia. Because nature always causes sterility to all the members of the sixth generation and ends that family branch, the members of that family, by making childless, thus keeping mankind pure from being totally polluted. So this is one of the features. Leukemia may be one of the features of the sixth generation of gonorrhea. And according to the standards of Hahnemann, the circumstantial causes like lack of affection in the childhood will not lead to leukemia unless there is psychosis in the family. So that the lack of affection works only as a stimulating cause, not the original cause. On an average scale, mental healing can cure only psychological diseases. But if the healer happens to be a true scientist, experimental scientist of the eightfold path of the yoga of Patanjali, he can cure even the miasmic and the deep-seated chronic diseases from a distance. Just as an electronic instrument, a radioactive instrument, can help or kill a person from a distance. But taken on the normal level, an average healer can heal only psychological and nervous diseases. But my first-hand experience is that my father, who was a master of the yoga path, cured lepers through his thought. So, a student of yogic science can cure the physical, the vital and the mental planes of a human constitution. Neurosis, you mean? In the case of neurosis, it is very easy. Distance is not a factor, just as it is not a factor in the radio transmitting and receiving sets. But we should be able to establish proper transmitting and proper receiving set between the healer and the patient. Just as the radio, only when it is properly tuned to the radio station, can receive the music, a patient can be cured of his neurosis from a distance only when he is devoted to the person who is curing. Devoted, he should be devoted to. And also when the healer is also devoted to mankind and really believes in the existence of God in all the human beings, then it is quite possible. The neurotic cases are very easy to be cured from any distance. Unless I understand the question, how can I answer? Language is a big barrier. Yes, if I properly understand your question, suppose A deceives B in her life, and again A wants to cure B. Is it your question, sir? Then the attempt to cure the person will be a second example of deception. Because a person who is a healer from a distance can never deceive anyone. Conversely, a person who can deceive others in life can never heal anyone from a distance. I think he means disappointed, not deceived. Please just find out, we'll answer him.
He was meaning deceived.
Once again, please.
He said,
what is the amount of independence in a part of a big machine which is working in a healthy way? And what is the concept of the liberty given to a hand of a person whose constitution is quite healthy? Is the hand free to move or not? It is free to move, but it has no existence of its own. Similarly, a healthy concept of liberty is a concept of inclusion and the fitness of individual in the society. It is the concept of fitness, the adaptability of the individual in the society, that can be called liberty. And other concepts of liberty can be understood as unhealthy signs of the mind, because the individual is only a part of the universe, and the individual is endowed with his own free will to act according to himself. A person walking in an aeroplane which is in air has his full liberty to move in the aeroplane in whichever direction he wants, and he can eat